Oh, what can I say? Today's video is like, I just want to make you aware. So, in case when you're coming to Delft in the future, like Netherlands, then don't do this, the mistake that I did. I got fined like 104 euros for just holding my phone in my bike, I mean bicycle. It was not my fault. So, let me explain what happened. 6 days back, today I got the fine, by the way. I'll open it now in front of you. It's like sent by the Central Justice Inquest Bureau. Let me open it. Is this? So I need to pay them 104 euros. Actually, they said me it's 95, but now I see it's 104, including 9 euro administration costs. It's hell expensive, so don't try to be fined because of any driving issues, maybe a car or maybe a bike. So always remember two things. When you are riding a bike in Netherlands, it's very bike friendly, but there are very strict rules. Always have lights on the front and also in the back. It may be any cheap light you can get in Action. I'll make a video on Action later. It can be very cheap. Like if you buy from Action or from university library, it will cost you somewhere around 1 euro or 2 euro for both the lights. So you must have that. Otherwise, you will get around 50 to 60 euro fine for not having one light, only one light. It's really expensive, and I know. And in my case, last year in 2019, I have heard about this. I didn't have that in my mind, but it was actually not my fault. When I was in Delft, I was studying from 2015 to 17. I never use phone while biking, like one hand on the handle and one hand on the phone, like doing some kind of social media, Instagram, Snapchat, or Twitter, or Facebook, or YouTube. But this time, what happened, I had to go like 1 kilometer. I could have walked. I thought I will walk, but then my friend said, like, why not take my bike and go? It was actually for doing a short interview for you guys, like from sharing someone's experience who was in aerospace. I don't know if you'll see that video by now or you'll see it in future. I'll share it. So I said, maybe I'll take the bike. It will save me 5 or 10 minutes. And I was just switching on the GPS on my phone. And I was keeping the phone in the pocket, and in the middle, I forgot the way. So I took the phone out of my pocket, and I cannot, like, that moment is like, it is always in my mind, like, why am I paying so much money? It is like the fine is so heavy here for even like a first person, first offense, that it keeps a mark in your head, indelible mark, so that you never repeat this mistake again. And I took out the phone from my pocket. It was very windy and rainy. That is the normal weather in Netherlands. I was in Delft and I was on my way. I just took it out from my pocket to see the arrow. It was like 10 or 15 seconds, hardly, only 10 or 15 seconds. And then there's like, I saw the arrow, and then I was seeing it, and I saw from the left there is a big van written Polizia. So the police people were passing, and then it struck to me suddenly, okay, you should not, even if you don't use social media, even for GPS, you should not hold a phone in one hand while riding the bike. So I stopped at that moment, and within 10-20 seconds, two officers came, one lady and one male officer, and they said, like, you are fine. Give me your identity card. They took pictures of them. Then I asked, like, why? They said, according to the Dutch law from 2019, you cannot, even while riding a bike, you cannot hold a phone. Even if you don't do anything with the phone, it's a smart device. You need to interact with it. So you cannot hold a phone in one hand and drive the bike. If you need to see the GPS, then you could have stopped somewhere and saw it. So it is like extreme bad luck and these circumstances, and according to them, according to the proper law, I am guilty. But so there is no grounds for appeal. They asked me, what's your defense? I said the same thing, that I have this issue of I was seeing the GPS for 10 seconds, and I was like, it's very difficult to describe. It was a very painful moment. I didn't expect to pay so much fine because of this minor thing which, but anyway, I just had this in my mind now that because here I have a holder for the phone, so I never hold the phone when I see the GPS. But there my friend's bike didn't have that, so I was holding it in my hand. But now I remember that either I walk or if I see the GPS, I just get down from my bike, see the GPS, put again the phone in my pocket. So always remember to have bike lights and never hold a phone. I would also advise you never to hold a camera. I don't know what's the law if you hold a camera in one hand and bike, because whatever videos I shoot with the camera, I rarely hold them. Now I don't think I'll ever hold them after paying 104 euros fine, which is really, really heavy, like 104 euros. So if you translate it, I was like, let me just translate it to be sure like what it means. Okay, so if I translate it, it actually means that they have given the account number and the time before which I need to pay the fine, would before, pay before, and where it happened, on which date. It happened 6 days ago in the municipality of Delft. And if you have, you can also appeal. If you don't agree, you can appeal. If I translate it using the Google Translate, so I can appeal before 14 April and then I can write it. Everything is online, I can pay it online, but it's very heavy fine. And if I have questions, or there's also a phone number, so they said they will send the ticket, and really I got a ticket. And so I can pay by IDL logging in, and also I can pay in parts. If I cannot pay within this 2 months, then I can pay partially and I can arrange that plan online. But if I miss it, then the fine is really, really heavy. So be careful of that. So the first, if I miss after first increase, the fine becomes 151.5 euro. And if I have a second increase of the fine, which is only 104, the fine becomes 151. If I have second notice and increase, then it becomes 294. It's almost three times, 294 euros. So you can imagine if you are in India and converting it to rupees. So I would advise you never to do these things so that you don't run into this trouble like I had because of unfortunate circumstances. I cannot do anything with that. So I will pay it right now after I shut down the camera. I hope you understand this concerning point, which was not very good, but I thought it is also good to share all these problems so that you don't face them when you come here or you are new here. And don't forget to share this video, help out your friends, subscribe to the channel, like this video, show some love so that it reaches to many people and everyone becomes aware of it. See you in my upcoming vlogs. Stay tuned, be happy, spread. Bye.